Good Monday morning! Today we're going to look at the class keyword in JavaScript. This video contains three segments. The first one is how does class work in JavaScript? This video talks about how a class works specifically in JavaScript. So I'm going to assume that you know what a class is in the general sense. The second part of the video deals with the fact that JavaScript does not have classes. I'm going to demonstrate how the class keyword is just syntactic sugar on top of the prototypal inheritance model. The third and final part of this video is called When in Rome, Learn JavaScript. In this segment, I'm going to try to convince you, if you are new to JavaScript and you're coming from another programming language, such as Java or C-sharp or whatever, to learn JavaScript properly and not try to force your existing mental model into JavaScript, because that will just cause you pain. That is what we are going to talk about today. I am MPJ, and you are watching Fun Fun Function. Before we begin, I would like to stress that this episode is part of a series. The purpose of this series is to really get into and understand how object creation in JavaScript works. Learn it properly, because we're programming in this language now, we should really learn its nooks and crannies. If you found this video by googling JavaScript classes, it's very tempting to just watch this video and try to get on with it, but please look at the series from the start instead. You can find it by clicking in the upper right corner or the link in the episode description. This will make you feel a lot less confused, and by having the fundamentals down, it will make you a calmer person and a better person, and you will thank me for it, I promise. If you're not a new viewer, however, you might be confused as to why I'm doing an object creation series, because I started this channel by doing a series on how to do functional programming in JavaScript, and I'm often vocal against doing too much object orientation. I don't think that you should not necessarily view this series as an endorsement of object orientation, but instead view it as a way of getting to know JavaScript intimately, because dismissing something because you know it and you're well familiar with it and you choose not to use it, that's wisdom. But if you don't know about something, you don't know it fully and don't know how to use it, and you avoid it, then that is not wisdom, that is just ignorance. All right, let's get into it. So classes in JavaScript, they work very much like you would expect. Let's create a class called mammal. And then we are going to create a new mammal. Call it with nothing, and yes, call it Fluffykins. Hello there, and let's echo out what Fluffykins is. Let's check what it is. Oh, it's an empty object. If you're interested, the plugin that I'm using for inline evaluation here is called Quokka. You can find a link in the episode description. Classes in JavaScript can have constructors, as you would expect them to have. Let's say constructor. And you can also assign properties to objects, like this dot, let's call this property sound. You can assign it, and let's see, I want this to use an argument, so constructors can have arguments. So let's say they call this sound. And then we also need to pass it down here. I'm going to call this woof there. So the property sound of Fluffykins is now woof. Nothing strange here. You can also do methods. So you perhaps call this talk, and it will just return whatever is inside this dot sound. So if I do Fluffykins dot talk, nothing happens. I need to return this dot sound, and this does not work either because I need to assign it to a variable, or Quokka won't evaluate it. Woof, 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 woof. I really should think of better examples than animals. But I like animals. They are cute, nice. And of course, classes in JavaScript can do inheritance. So let's do class dot dog extends mammal. And we're going to give it a constructor. It will take no arguments, and it's going to call super, which is basically calling the constructor of the inherited class. So super here is actually going to call the constructor of mammal here, because we are inheriting mammal. So we're going to pass in sound here. Let's call this woofly woof. And let's change Fluffykins to be a dog and remove this and see if this works. Did it work? Why doesn't it work? Let's open the terminal. Super keyword unexpected here? What is happening? Oh, it's because I'm typing contractor. Constructor. There. Now it works. Woofly, 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 woof. I am the best at programming. I would like to make a side warning here. We're seeing some inheritance here. Be very careful about using inheritance. It's very problematic. It's a problematic pattern, and you should prefer composition in almost all cases. You might want to look at my video Composition over Inheritance by clicking in the upper right corner or in the episode description. But that's a side note, we're not passing judgment on that right now. I am very, very bright. Perhaps I should, like, drop the thing. Let's drop the thing. Perhaps this is better. Yeah, that's better. So far, the class keyword in JavaScript works like we'd expect if we are coming from a Java or C# background. Or any other programming language, mostly, that has classes. But there are weird things that work not like you'd expect. For example, there is no way for us to make this sound property here private. There's no way for me to say something like private sound. It's there's no such thing, and there's no trick to do it either. So I can always do. Let me show you. Let y equals fluffykins dot sound, and I can do y. You see, I can access it from outside, and I can also change it. So let's say I can call it fluffykins equals 1. No, sorry, I can. That will break. Fluffykins dot sound. And now it says 1, or I could just go meow. You see, since private members do not exist in JavaScript, you often see people doing underscore as a convention to indicate that this is a private member and that you should not mess with it if you're using the class. But, you know, I can still just mess with it. It's very brittle. At this point, you might be asking yourself, why doesn't the class keyword in JavaScript have support for private members? It seems weird because the class keyword was added very recently to JavaScript. It was added just a few years ago. Why didn't they add this? It seems like a very basic type of functionality. That's a great question, and the answer is that JavaScript does not have classes. It's all fake. In the previous episode about the new keyword, we talked about how JavaScript fakes classes. In that episode, we looked at how the new keyword could be applied to a constructor function, and together with the prototype that kind of faked something that behaved just like a class. But it wasn't really a class, it was just kind of, sort of looking like a class. And the class keyword in ES6 is really just like that. It's just a bit prettier syntactic sugar. It's all smoke and mirrors. Allow me to demonstrate. I'm going to do this. Type of dog. It's a function. No, it's a function because classes do not exist in JavaScript. It's just a thin layer on top of the old prototypal inheritance. It just looks a little bit prettier. So let's see if I can just do dog.prototype talk. There we have our talk method. It's this one here. And if I just call this immediately, we're going to get an error. No, not an error, but undefined because it doesn't have a this.sound property. Let's see if we can... I'm going to do something now. If you understand it, that will yield you a golden star because I'm going to be using all of the things that we've been learning in this series so far. Let's see here. Talk.bind, and we're going to bind it to a new this. The first argument to bind is redefining this, and we're going to call it be an object with the property sound, and we're going to call it it's hard to invent sound. Let's call it roar. And then we call that function and then it goes roar. So what just happened there is that we called bind with this object here, an object with the property underscore sound. And that means that what bind does is that it creates a new version of talk where we have bound this to be this object here. So it creates a new function and returns it, and then we call it here with this. And also, I think I can do this actually. Dog.prototype is prototype of Fluffykins. Yes, true. So you see, class is just a very thin layer on top of the prototypal inheritance. There is no class-based inheritance in JavaScript. It's all just smoke and mirrors. So the class keyword has basically been welded onto JavaScript because there was a lot of pressure to do it. And the reason there was a lot of pressure to do it is that there's a lot of new programmers coming into JavaScript. Not new programmers as in newbies, but new programmers from other backgrounds. C#, C++, Java. Programmers are coming in that are used to languages that are A, heavily object-oriented, and B, they have a classical inheritance model. They are class-based. So they're very used to this, and they don't want to learn the prototypal inheritance model that JavaScript has, and they don't want to learn the functional programming model that JavaScript has. They want JavaScript to be like the programming language that they already know. And I don't want to fault people for that too much because looking up how to do a class was one of the first things I did when I started learning JavaScript. In my mind, adding the class keyword to JavaScript was a little bit like, I might get in trouble for this, giving clean needles to meth addicts. It is a distinct improvement over using dirty needles to do meth, but if we can, we should try to get people off meth. Which brings me to the third segment, when in Rome, write JavaScript. Try to embrace JavaScript and its strengths and learn to write JavaScript in a way that is natural to JavaScript. Do not try to force the existing models that you have from whatever language, Java or C#, into JavaScript. And the reason you want to do that is that if you don't, is that you will always have this sense of unease and uncertainty about what is happening. when you're looking in the Chrome inspector and you see these prototype things of your with underscores on your classes, you will just feel, what is this? You will just feel not at ease because you don't understand what it is that you're doing. Because you're using this thing that is kind of looks like a class, but it really is trying to hide some internal implementation from you, but it does a bad job of it. So it just gives you this weird sense of, I don't have control. And if you don't understand the prototypal inheritance model and that classes is just a thin layer on top of it, you will not understand its limitations. You won't understand why there is no such thing as private members, and you will just be angry about that limitation, but you won't understand the context about the thing that you're angry about, and that will give you a sense of not being in control, and the world is against you. And this is not just about learning about the prototypal inheritance model of JavaScript, it's also about learning about the functional nature of JavaScript, because that ties into object creation in JavaScript a lot, because there's a lot of weirdness with bind and this that you won't really understand without understanding the functional nature of JavaScript. So if you want to feel comfortable writing JavaScript and know really what you're doing, you should check out this series from the start if you haven't already, and you should also check out the my functional programming in JavaScript series, because that ties into object creation a lot. That is it for today. We talked a little bit about how a class works in JavaScript. Then we explored how JavaScript doesn't have classes. And finally, I ranted a little bit about how, when in Rome, write JavaScript. If anything was unclear, or if you would like an elaboration, please write a comment down below and I will try to answer it. You have just watched an episode of Fun Fun Function. I release these every Monday morning, 0800 GMT. If you don't want to wait until next Monday, you can check out this episode that Google's machine learning thingamabob has selected for your viewing pleasure. I am MPJ. Until next Monday morning, stay curious.